Okay, good morning class. So we are now going to continue the farm power. This is lesson 2.2 part 2. So we are going to continue on different sources of power in the farm. Now we'll discuss what is heat engine. So heat engine produces heat energy by burning fuel within or outside the engine and convert it to mechanical energy to drive generators and other machines. These engines are found ordinarily in large-scale farming. So there are two types of heat engine. So the first one is external combustion engine, or ECE, and the second one is the internal combustion engine, or ICE. External combustion engine are engines where the fuel such as coal and others are burned outside the engine body to produce power. This includes steam engine and gas turbines used in old transport system. So the idea here is to burn like coal, and then it produces steam, and the steam drives the piston to rotate the crankshaft and drives the engine, drive the machine. So that is the external combustion engine. The internal combustion engine, most common nowadays, where the fuels such as gasoline, dieseline, alcohol, and other hydrocarbons are burned inside the engine body to produce power. So this is called internal combustion engine because the burning of the fuel happens inside the engine body. So gasoline and diesel engines are under this classification. Gasoline engines are also called spark ignition engines, while diesel engines are also known as compression ignition engines. So I'll be discussing that later. So on our left is the kind of example of a gasoline engine. This is the engine that you can find in your motorcycles. So this is a single piston or single cylinder engine. So here, the idea here is that in the intake valve here, this will be open. First it will open. So when this is open, the fuel comes in together with air, and the spark plug, the spark plug will provide a spark, and it will burn the fuel here. So there is a burning of the fuel, and the gases expands. So the expansion of the gases here will push this piston. This is a piston downward, due to the expansion of the gas. So pag push din his piston going downward, this will rotate the crank here. Pag push niya din, it will rotate, and then once it goes back, kani i-push po niya ang gases, and then it will open this valve here. Exhaust valve will push, will open, and the air or the burnt gases, ang mga aso, this will be exited here, mugawas din ng dapita. So this is the cycle, So that's why this crankshaft here will continuously rotate, in the engine. So that is the idea of the kining gasoline engine with the spark plug. In the right, this is a diesel engine. And a diesel engine is quite bigger, So this might have four cylinders, upat ka ingon ani na dire. So gasoline engines has also kining mga cars, like for example kining mga kutsi usually have four cylinders, ang mga multi-cab, maybe they have three cylinders, no? The more cylinders or pistons they have, the higher, no, the power. So ang difference lang sa diesel o sa gasoline, sa diesel is compression. The burning of the fuel is based on the compression. Once the diesel fuel is compressed, no, it will create a high temperature and that causes the burning of the fuel. Okay, so an engine is a device which, when provided with fuel and air, produces a rotary power. The efficiency of the conversion of the chemical energy in the fuel to mechanical energy at the engine output is not high. The maximum efficiencies are usually in the range of 25% to 35% for gasoline and 30% to 40% for diesel engines. Now, from the engine, the power is generated in the engine, no? So it will be transferred to the machines, like for example pump, no, or kaning other mga application like corn dehusker, no. So we will be transmitting the power, no. So we have different methods in transmitting power. The first one is the direct drive. A machine is directly driven from the shaft of an electric motor or an internal combustion engine. There is usually a clutch or a flexible coupling between the power source and machine. So we have here an example, like for example feed mills, no, and centrifugal water pumps. So what you can see here is an example of a direct drive, no. We say direct drive, if this is the engine, so the shaft of the engine is directly connected to the shaft of the, this is the water pump, no, using a coupler. So the coupler is actually the connecting element between the shaft of the engine and shaft of the pump, no? So that is direct drive. So next one is the pulley and belt system, no. So belts may be either flat or V-shaped. So this one you can see here in the picture is a flat belt, no, connected in the flat pulley system. So I hope you have visited this place, water wheel. You cannot be considered viscans kung dili ka makamsita aning building, no. This is a water powered stripping machine. So the power from the falling water sa gawas ani na ay dako nga wheel, no, gitawag ni water wheel because it is the water that is moving these big mga pulleys. So the movement of water outside will cause this pulley, big pulley, to rotate, and then the power from the water is transmitted to this belt, no. And you know, you see this shafting here, this is connected to this actually here, no. So the power is transmitted through this pulley and then through this belt, no. That's why this will rotate the pulley of the stripping machine. This is the stripping machine that is used to extract the fiber, abaca fiber. So this is the water powered stripping machine, no. So water is used in the in stripping the abaca fiber. Okay, so what is the relationship between rotation speed and the pulley diameter, no? So it is very important also. For example, in this case, if we have this, we see this is the driver pulley and this is the driven pulley, no? So when on the driver, this is directly connected to the engine, no? And then this is the driven, so mo ni ang murag output here. No. Take note that if the pulley connected to the engine is bigger and the pulley, kinimani ang pulley, driven pulley is smaller, the result is that it will produce higher speed here, no? Mas paspas ang tuyok diri, no? So this is the relationship. D1, or the diameter of the driver pulley, multiplied by the speed n, or rotational speed of pulley 1, kani ang yang speed sa pagtuyok, is equal to the diameter of the driven pulley multiplied by the speed of the driven pulley, no? So okay, so to illustrate, no, we'll have this sample problem. Okay, so we will solve this problem. A 6 cm diameter pulley drives a 12 cm diameter pulley. Find the rotational speed of the driven pulley if the driver pulley rotates at 200 rpm in a no slip condition. With a slip or sliding and creeping stretching loss of 4%, what is the new rotational speed of the driven pulley? So, okay, so we will try to solve this one. So we have, we are given the driver pulley is 6 centimeters, no? And the rotational speed is 200 RPM. Then our driven pulley is 12 centimeter, and we are required to find for the rotational speed of the driven pulley. First is at no slip, meaning to say walay sliding, and the second condition is that with a slip of 4%, meaning to say naasya sa 96% efficiency, no? So solution, you just directly apply the equation, which is D1 multiplied by N1 is equal to D2 over N2, no? So we are looking for N2, so we have to transfer the unknown value, the unknown to the left side. So we have N2, D2 equals D1, N1, so we are looking for N2. So we have N2 is equal to D1 times N1 over D2. So D1, substituting the values, we have D1 is 6 centimeters and N1 is 200 RPM. And then D2 is 12 centimeters, no? So the result is that N2 is equal to 100 RPM, no? So at no slip, and for N2 with a slip of 4%, N2 is equal to 100 RPM. No, so take note, our driver is smaller and our driven pulley is big. So that's the reason why we notice here that the RPM getting smaller, no, from 200 to 100 RPM. So going back, so the result is 100 RPM for no slip and 96% for 96 RPM for the loss of 4%, no? So continue, the length of belt connection, no? For example, if you have your purais nga galingan, and you have this belt na putol, so how are you going to compute for the replacement of the belt, no? So this is the formula for finding for the length of the belt that is needed, no? So LO is the length of belt, the D is the diameter of the bigger pulley in centimeter, small d is the diameter of the smaller pulley, and C is the distance between the centers of the pulleys in centimeter, no? So in solving the problem, you just have to supply all the values and you can solve the problem. Now, for example, in this case here, we have a problem, two pulleys 10 and 20 centimeters in diameter respectively are 100 centimeter apart at center, no? How long should the belt be to drive the belt and pulley transmission system? So we are given diameter of the pulley is 20 centimeters and the diameter of the small pulley is 10 centimeter, and the distance between the centers of the small and big pulleys is 100 centimeter, and we are asked to find for the length of the belt, no? So solution, so knowing our formula, LO is equal to pi over 2 multiplied by the diameter plus the diameter of the small pulley plus 2 times the distance of the center of the small and big pulley, and plus the square of the difference between the small and big pulley over 4C. So we have length is equal to 3.1416, which is the pi over 2, and we have our diameter is 20 plus 10 for the small plus 2 times, and distance is 100 centimeter plus difference of the big and small, which is 10 square over 4 times 100. Okay, so we have our LO, this is the length of the belt, this is 47.124 centimeter, no? So plus 200, then 20 minus 10 is 10, the square of 10 is 100, so 100 centimeter square over 4 times 100 is 400 centimeter. So cancel na to ang centimeter, 1 na lang ang centimeter mahibilin sa taas, no? So computing 47.124 plus 200, that is 247.124. So 100 over 400 is 0.25, no? 0.25. So we have our length, which is equal to 247.37 centimeters. So this is our answer. So try to practice and solve some problems. So we have our result is 247.37. Now we'll proceed. We have V-belts, no? V-belts are employed extensively in agricultural machinery applications wherein it is not necessary to maintain exact speed ratios. They tend to cushion shock loads, do not require lubrication, and are less critical to misalignment than other types of drives. However, B-belts are not suitable for heavy loads at low speeds. So these are mga advantages of using V-belts, no? Because it's quieter and it's also not too sensitive kung dili align ang mga pulleys, no? And it absorb the loads or shocks, no? Kanang mga kalit-kalit nga mga loads, no? So V-belts can transmit a given amount of power with less overall shaft pull than a flat belt drive because a V-belt wedges into the shift grooves. A V-belt transmit power by virtue of the difference in belt tension between the point at which it enters a shift and the point at which it leaves. So, mamuni advantage sa kanang V-belt as compared to flat belt because kung V-belt mas dako siya surface area nga mas hugot-hugot siya, no, mas tighter ang iyang connection between the belt and the kining kwan pulley, no. So these are example of V-belts. So daghang klase nga mga V-belts also, no. So this is made of rubber na ay kanang na ay mga metal dinhi, no, to prevent from excessive kanang tension, no, moinat or so ang mga parts dinhi is that kini mo ni ang shave. So usually ang V-belt, ang belts nasa yung mga tightener. This one, this pulley is a tightener. So mauni ang driver, mauni ang driven. So naapod siya yung tightener. So, especially kung dugol, dugol siya kayo, no. So the power output from a V-belt drive, power is equal to the B, which is the belt speed, multiplied by the difference between the tight side tension and the slack side tension. So T minus TS is actually the effective pull in Newton. So I'm summoning tight side or slack side tension. So I will show you asaning kaning tight side. So if this is the driver pulley and it is rotating in a counterclockwise direction, so this is the driver pulley, and supposing this is the driven pulley, no, ang driven pulley mauna siya ang murag output, no, ang driver pulley, again I said this is directly connected to the engine. So ang kining kuan dinhi, this is the tight side of the belt, no, because this is rotating this direction, kini ang driver pulley, no. So mao to siyang direction, no. So mao to ang tight side, mao po to ang slack side, no. Okay, so for example, we have this problem: determine the power transmitted in a V-belt drive if the tension at the tight and slack side is 112 and 95 newtons respectively, while the belt is moving around the shift at 15 meters per second. No, so we are given tight side is 112 newtons and the slack side is 95 newtons, and the speed is 15 meters per second. So just applying the formula, no, then you can solve. So just try to follow and solve this, whether you can get the value of 0.255 kilowatt, no? So kilo again is 1000 watts, you know. So next is, aside from the belt and pulley, we have the sprocket, wheel and chain. These types of chain commonly used in power transmission on farm equipment. So we are familiar with this, no? Because kita mantag mga bicycle, misas kini mga bicycle, they are using the ruler chain, no? So kining hook link chain is used where the power requirement is low and the speed is relatively slow, no? So gamit ni sa mga farm implement, no? Pero dili kayo ni siya common, no? But this one B, ruler chain, is more common. It's more efficient than a hook link chain since the rulers reduce friction against the sprocket teeth, no? So we are so familiar with this. Okay, bicycles are using this roller chain na system of transmission. Now the effective length of one chain link is called the pitch, no? So computing for the total length of chains, for example, palit mo kanang chain para i-connect sa inyong bisikleta, no? So this is how it is computed. Actually, more similar po ni sa kuan katong length of belt, only they are using number of teeth, no, instead of diameter, no? So CL is the chain length and T is the number of teeth. P is the pitch, on summoning pitch, and C is the center distance between sprockets, no? So this is the pitch, no, meaning connection between chain, no? So mo na ang pitch. So applying the formula, so we have here an example. We'll just go directly to the answer, no? So that we will not have our video very long. So I have 12 tooths and a 26 tooth sprocket are positioned 16 inches away from each other on a center. How long is the chain needed to connect the above sprockets if a pitch is 1/2 inch long? So we are given T1 is 12 teeth, T2 is 26 teeth, center distance is about 16 inches, and pitch is 0.5 inches. So the length of chain is the required. So using the formula given earlier, so you can just supply all those values and computing, then we have this length of total length of in pitches, no, of the chain that you will be needing. Okay, so next is the speed of chain. So computing for the speed of chain, no? So speed of chain is equal to the chain pitch in mm or inches over 1000. Actually, we are looking into the speed which is in meter per seconds, no? That's why we have this 1000, because to convert the mm into meter, no? Because we have here the sprocket rotation is revolution per minute, no? Revolution per minute. So that's why we have 60 over here to convert this meter into 60, because we want to have our speed in meters per second, no? So T is the number of teeth on the sprocket. So giving this example, calculate the chain speed in meters per second for a 13 mm pitch chain around a 26 tooth sprocket rotating at about 33 revolution per minute. So writing the given, looking for the required, then applying the solution, knowing our equation, so just supply all the information, then computing, we have the speed of chain at 0.185 meter per second. So aside from belt and pulley and sprocket and chain, we have now next is the gears. No, gears are employed to transmit power if the machine is rather compact and the shafts are close together. So this, you see here the different types of gears, no? And these different gears have different functions. Nay ubana ni to change the direction of motion, to change the speed of motion, to change the the angle of motion, no? So we have here A is the spur gear, B is the cluster, the C is internal spur, D is a ring bone, E is helical, F is worm and worm wheel, G the straight bevel, H is straight bevel gear, then I is spiral bevel set, used in tractors, and J is hypoid gear set, and K is the spline shaft. No? So just be familiar with it. So relation of rotational speed between two gears. So this is an example of spur gears. No, so again, this is similar with the rotational speed of the belt and pulley. Not only in this case, they are using number of teeth. No. So T here is the number of teeth of the first gear. For example, this is the driving pulley, and T2 is the driven gear. Here, no. So N1, N is the rotation of the first gear or the driving gear, and N2 is the rotation of the driven gear. No, take note, it's also different in the belt system, pulley and belt system, because in the in gears, if the rotation of the first gear is in this direction, the gear that is attached is rotating in the different direction. Unlike in the belt and pulley, kung ang rotation sa pulley is in this direction, the pulley on the second is also rotating in the same direction, but in the gear system, mabali na siya, no? So we have here an example, a gear with 15 teeth drives a gear with 75 teeth. If the speed of the driving gear is 55 RPM, what is the speed of the driven gear? So we are given driver is 15 teeth, driven gear is 75 teeth, and driver is 55 revolution per minute. And so we are required to find for the speed of the driven gear. So applying the formula, N1 T1 is equal to N2 T2. So we are looking for N2. So we have to transfer that to the left side. So N2 times 75 teeth equal to 55 times 15 teeth. So the result is 11 revolution per minute. So try to solve this yourselves now, kung you can arrive the same answer of 11 revolution per minute. Okay, so next is the shaft and universal joint, no? So this is the shaft. Kani din he, kani mo ni ang mga shaft. So the universal joint is this one. Kani Power is transmitted from a tractor to an implement by means of a shaft called the power take-off shaft. During field operation, turning of corners is required. The power take-off shaft may be equipped with at least two universal joints to permit these turns. A complete shaft, including a universal joint, is called a power take-off drive. Shafts and universal joints are frequently employed also to transmit power at various angles on particular implement. No? So this is this universal joint is very useful. Kay sometimes kanang dili align ang shaft dire ug ang shaft dire. No, during tractors kung magliko siya ang tractor ang giguyod nga implement, for example, harrow, mabikil siya. So using this universal joint, bisan kung mag different angle na ang iyang shafting din na, still okay ra gyapon, no? Without problem. Kay this universal joint allows kining mga angles, no, sila mahimog na maghimog correction. Okay, so this is the power take-off shaft universal joints and integral safety shield. No? So, you can also see this in mga cars. No? So, inyong tinaon sa ilawom kung naabay power take-off shaft. No? Close-up of a universal joint between a gearbox and a drive shaft. So, mauni ang universal joint. No? Nag-cross na ay murag cross bearing. Nila. Okay, so lastly, we have the flexible shaft. A flexible shaft used to transmit power from an input source to an output in situations where many obstacles are present. A typical flexible shaft assembly consists of a cable spring, wire rope or cable, a flexible casing shaft end fittings and casing ends fittings. No? So, kining mga flexible shaft, they can just be positioned anywhere. No? Okay. Not necessarily na kinanglan siya naka-align, because it's, if this rotates, this portion also will rotate. No? So, that is the use of flexible shaft. Now, lastly is the hydraulic system. The hydraulic power lifts are used for raising, lowering, and controlling almost all types of field equipment. Now, I would like to dwell on this, on the principle of hydraulic system, so that you will also know what is this. No? So, for example, if we have a small cylinder, so connected to a bigger cylinder, no? Here is one. Then the pressure or the force applied to the small cylinder will result to raising of the load in the big cylinder. So na sila yung cylinder and these are connected with kaning oil, for example, or any fluid, no? So the area in the small cylinder or piston is AX, and the big cylinder or piston is AY. Since we know that pressure is equal to force over area, and for example, here the pressure is PX and the pressure of the other side is PY in the bigger cylinder, and the principle of hydraulic is that the pressure at X is equal to the pressure at PY, you know? So since pressure is equal to force over area, so we can say that this is equal to the force Y over area Y, no? And see, if we look for the force output if Y, putting it then left side because it's unknown, so we have Fy times Ax. So now Fy, our unknown, is equal to Ax times Fx Ay. And then since we are looking for the Fy, so we have Fx times Ay over Ax. So this is our equation. So this is it, no? So we have to be familiar with this principle. Now, an example of the hydraulic application. I don't know if you are familiar with this. This is hydraulic jack, no? The principle of a hydraulic jack, no? So can you apportion? This is a piston ram. This is the pump shaft here. Na din he ang gamay ng piston or the pump, no? So when you press this one here, the fluid inside will push the piston din he sa piston ram. So din he mo i-apply ang imong force to pump, so ang fluid mo saka sa diri i-push niya ning kuan piston ram diri. So mao ni ang hydraulic jack nga gamiton sa mga truck, no, sakyanan, to lift the, for example, na platan ang inyo sakyanan. So this is the one that will lift the car, no, in order nga matanggal ang ligid, no. So we have an example, no, so that you will value the example that we have. So we have again, no, the problem. The problem is how heavy is the car that can be lifted by an hydraulic jack having a ram with cross-sectional area of 4 cm square? If the force of Fx is, the applied force is 10 kilograms, was applied in the 0.008 cm square pump or piston. Ito nga, kita ganiha nga hydraulic jack, no? So, unsa kuno ka bugaton sa truck or car nga malift, no, using this system of hydraulic jack. So to solve, we are given Fx is 10 kilograms. This is the force that we applied in the hydraulic jack or in the piston. And the area of the piston pump is 0.008 square centimeter. And the area of the piston ram, so dito sa output, no, is 4 centimeter square. So we are asked to find for how heavy ang load nga maalsa, which is Fy. So solutions from the formula that we generate, we have Fy is equal to Fx multiplied by Ay over Ax. So Fy is equal to, our Fx is 10 kilograms multiplied by area, which is 4 centimeter square, over our Ax is 0.008 centimeter square. So cancel ang centimeter square, So we have our FY, which is the load to be lifted, is about 5,000 kilograms. What is 5,000 kilograms? So it is equivalent to 1,000 kilogram is equal to 1 ton. So we have 5 tons. So imagine the hydraulic jack can lift 5 tons nga car, no? So mao na siya ang capacity po sa hydraulic jack, no? It can lift a bigger kuan kaning mga do, depende sa ka unsa ka capacity sa hydraulic jack. So in our example, we are able to lift a 5 ton truck, no? Ang mga kutsi is only about 2 tons or 3 tons. So meaning to say, kumayong tag 5 tonners ng mga truck, it is big truck, no? So try to exercise in solving problems. Sunod-sunuran ninyo ang mga examples that we can have, we have, so that try to see if you derive same answer to practice, no? So I think that ends our topic on farm power. Thank you very much.